months of waiting and numerous leaks, the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus is now official at Mobile World Congress. Yes, it looks very much the same like its predecessor, but what's really changed is on the inside. I'm Warren with KL Gadget TV, and here's the first look of the Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus. If you happen to put both the S8 and the S9 side by side, you're going to have a hard time differentiating them, as they both have the same infinity display with a thin forehead and chin. Once you pick up the S9, the perception is somehow different from the S8, which the first thing you will notice is the aluminum frame, which Samsung has switched away from the glossy chrome material on the S8, and it's a really good change, since it no longer scratches easily. The S9 still has a fingerprint magnet glass back like the S8, and the good news here is that the fingerprint sensor is now located just below the camera. Well, this should have been the S8's initial design. One thing I'm happy about the S9 is that it now comes with stereo speakers tuned by AKG and with support for Dolby Atmos. This is something that I've always wished Samsung has included on their flagships for the longest time. The headphone jack is still there, and both the S9 and S9 Plus comes with water resistance, fast wireless charging, but wired charging speed remains the same as the S8. Like how Apple releases an S variant of the iPhone, the Galaxy S9 is technically an S version of the Galaxy S8 with improved performance hardware. Depending on where the S9 is sold, the phones will either come with a Snapdragon 845 or Exynos 9810 system on chip. The S9 comes with 4GB of RAM, while the S9 Plus comes with 6GB of RAM. Storage options are available in either 64, 128, and 256GB with support for microSD expansion. The cameras are probably the largest hardware update here. Both the S9 and S9 Plus's camera supports dual aperture. The S9 Plus gets a secondary lens for telephoto shots. Samsung references the dual aperture feature to the human eye, which the camera is able to react to total darkness and super bright lighting conditions to capture photos with accurate exposure and detail. It works between the aperture range of f1.5 through f2.4, and with the help of OIS, the S9's camera is set to excel in super low light conditions. One of the more interesting things about the S9's camera software would be AR Emojis, a direct competition to Apple's Animoji, but a more flexible solution. Since the S9 doesn't come with a sophisticated set of sensors found on the iPhone X, you might find it to be less accurate in capturing facial reactions than Apple's Animojis. But nonetheless, it still works fine all thanks to the company's AR core framework and a front-facing 8MP f1.6 sensor. One thing I love about AR Emojis is that it isn't built directly into Samsung's messaging app or limited to it, but rather, it works directly from the camera app. To set it up, you first need to take a selfie to register your face by switching over to the AR Emoji camera mode. I was actually pretty surprised at how well it turned my face into a cartoon figure that is close enough to my features. And from there onwards, I can customize my facial tone, change my glasses, hairstyle, and clothes. You can record a video using the AR emoji you just created as long as you want, and also choose from a wide variety of AR emoji characters, which you can later share to any social apps that you want. Bixby Vision has gotten a huge update this time on the S9, and it doesn't just only recognize objects, but it also lets you try on things such as makeups, which Samsung has partnered with Sephora to let users try out cosmetics directly on their face with the help of AR. It's really fun, and I really can't wait to see more retail partners using Bixby Vision to let customers try out their products without visiting a physical store. The Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus will be available March 16 onwards. Pre-orders should start first week of March, while we should expect prices to remain around the same as the Galaxy S8. The S9 and S9 Plus are available in 4 colors of Midnight Black, Coral Blue, Titanium Grey, and Lilac Purple. There are more stuff to find out on the Galaxy S9, and I'll share more of my opinions when I get my review unit. But do let me know if you have any questions in the comments, and be sure to stay tuned to more coverage of Mobile World Congress this week. Subscribe to KL Gadget TV, share this video, and I'll see you in the next one.